Greetings and welcome to an episode of the almost world famous Cactus Atlas. Today we're going to be exploring a sampling of things at the Valley of Fire State Park in the beautiful state of Nevada. There are many very iconic things to see in this park, some that take a long time to do and some that don't. Today we're focusing on a list of the smaller, easy to bite off things you can do here in this state park. So if you want to find out, join me and let's go discover together. So Elephant Rock is right by the one of the entry gates, and you can see it's the first stop for many where they pay their fees and makes Elephant Rock really popular, I think. All right, so I'm now on the Elephant Rock Trail. And you can see it looks like an elephant. So you get just what was advertised, Elephant Rock. I've seen photos of this before, and it does not disappoint in person. It's a little bit bigger than an regular elephant, but not by much. It's got the shape and size. So the region around Elephant Rock is also pretty spectacular. Awesome views. Come right off the road to get some great photos. I even see an arch up there. You can see way down there is where we parked. You can see our car, in fact, and way off into the distance too, towards Overton, which is going to be up that way. So you do have to walk a little ways to get to Elephant Rock, and I didn't realize that it was like kind of up on a hill and you're not supposed to climb up on the rocks. So I got a couple shots. It's so windy today though that I have rare moments where I can actually film and get audio, so I wasn't able to really comment on anything up there, but it was actually pretty cool. I used to collect Arizona Highway magazines, and I had issues from the 1970s. I believe one of them was the one that had the Elephant Rock on the cover. And ever since seeing that, I've always wanted to visit this location, so I can finally check that off my bucket list. So Elephant Rock is pretty iconic. I've seen it in photos before visiting here. And if you come in through the east entrance by Overton, it is right there next to the guard gate. I mean right there where you pay your entrance fee if you have to do self-pay. And you basically just park and walk up right over there and you'll see this thing. So is it worth a stop? 100% for sure, because it's only gonna take you 5 minutes maybe to go up there, snap a couple Instagram photos and head back down. So, and it's not a difficult trail at all. So anybody can get this one done. Hey look, I'm at the Seven Sisters. Guess what that means? Time for 11Z's. Just kind of an on-the-go snack station. You also have grills here at the Seven Sisters stop, which is nice. Let's go explore this area back here behind the Seven Sisters and see if we can get a better view. So that's where I had my lunch down there, and I guess that's one of the Seven Sisters, I'm guessing. Two, three for sure. I can't really count because they wrap around that way. But you see and get the gist of it, right? You got Big Rock Pavilion, Big Rock Pavilion, Big Rock Pavilion approximately for a stretch. So there's lots of little areas like that to sit and eat and get away from crowds. They do have restroom facilities here, even though they are vault toilets, but they're pretty clean. This is one of the things I love about Valley of Fire. When you just walk around and explore, you'll find like awesome places like this where the train in front frames a really cool background. So I think there's a lot of cool photograph moments you can find in this park, this being one of them that I just found. And the view you get facing out this way with your back to the rocks ain't too bad either, is it? And I also want to point out they have an accessible pavilion. You've got handicap spots over there, and this is very nicely paved. So overall, my thoughts about the Seven Sisters is that if you're going to be eating a quick picnic lunch out of your car, this place is ideal. It's awesome that you have all those cool pavilions spread out like you do and get privacy. When you're done eating, like I did, you can just do a quick stroll behind like where the parking lot is on the other side and then view the Seven Sisters up close and personal. So my next stop is something called the Cabins, which we're on our way to. We turned off the main road to go this way, and then I noticed this here, and I looked at my map. This is known as Lone Rock. It's very aptly named, wouldn't you agree? Now all this really is a day use area. It's got a picnic table and grill and trash can. Had I known of this lone rock before I stopped at Seven Sisters, I may have wanted to go for this since you're pretty much alone out here at this stop. Although Seven Sisters was awesome, so I don't regret doing that. But the next time I take a picnic lunch, maybe tomorrow, I think I'm gonna do it here at Lone Rock. There's also a trail here at Lone Rock. Let's see where it goes. It looks short, I'm guessing. Maybe you get a good view up there, but yeah, seeing all these boulders off of this formation is actually pretty cool. I haven't seen anything kind of like that where you've got bushes sprinkled in up on the hillside with the fallen rocks. It's actually a very neat looking scene back here. So the trail just keeps on winding over this way, but you're really coming up on these really tall cliffs here with all the fallen rocks. It makes you feel very small over here. Anyway, what I love about these stops, if you walk a little ways, look at how that photo in front of me there, like it's such a good photo opportunity. The landscape rolls in front of me with all the bushes. So that's worth a stop to get a couple snapshots here, guys. Also looks like people ventured up that way. It looks pretty well worn. I'm gonna skip that today, but I do want to encourage you, stop over there at Lone Rock and walk out over here and check this out. Clearly, Lone Rock was not on my itinerary for today. I just saw it, decided to stop, check it out. Spent a grand total of maybe like 5 minutes here. So if you have 5 minutes to spare, do it. If not, don't worry about it. Just drive on by. So right up there are the cabins, which were built by the Civilian Conservation Corps back around 1935. And this was used over time to house campers and visitors to the park, which now it's a stop on the tour. Now let's go check out one of these bad boys here. Oh, look at that. They have a little fireplace in here. I'm guessing that's the original wood. These would be pretty comfortable, actually. It's all stone and very dirty floor, but I could totally see myself camping in one of these. There are a couple of these actually to check out. Ooh, this one's even nicer. Much nicer fireplace, nicely angled against the wall there. There's something inscribed, it looks like here. Looks like a petroglyph almost, doesn't it? And one more to check out here. Huh, this one, the floor's a lot cleaner. Wow, I take that back. Yeah, another like nice curved wall. They all are kind of unique, aren't they? They do have restrooms here. And here's a little picnic area found here at the Valley of Fire cabins stop with your pink trash cans. And a grill, a filthy looking grill, and a few tables, very nicely shaded over here. So the cabins, is it worth a stop? Same thing with a lot of other things here. If you have the time and you have more than a day to see the park, totally. I really enjoy this. It's really cool to be in these structures and try to imagine what it was like staying here as a guest for whatever reason. They're kind of cozy too. You have a nice fireplace. So definitely, if you have time, make a stop. Why not? So up on that hill behind me is what's known as Petrified Logs East. I did Petrified Logs West earlier yesterday. So we'll see what this one's like. So from the parking lot, which is right here, you just simply take up these stairs. I see one spot up there where there's like a fence and it looks like it's gonna go up this hill. Not sure how much further after that, but it doesn't look too bad of a climb. And you can see the parking lot. I ascended this trail. So, no big deal so far. Behold the Petrified Log. Just as advertised once again, Petrified Log. At least Petrified Log number one I assume we have to go up there to get more views of Petrified Logs. This trail is a little bit more strenuous, I noticed, than a lot of the other ones I've done so far. So I'm not willing to really say how well suited this is. A lot of loose dirt down here, gravel, kind of slippery and very steep. So it turns out there's really no Petrified Logs up on that hill anywhere, unless I missed it, but I don't think I did. The only one to see is down that way. However, the views up there are amazing. I just couldn't really film and talk too much because it's so gusty today. And at the top of the hill, the wind is just rip-roaring nonstop. Whoa. So Petrified Logs East, was it worth it? Pretty much the same answer I gave you, I think, for Petrified Logs West. It is, if you have time. There's only one log here, whereas on the west side, they have like three or four logs. So if you're gonna choose between one of the two Petrified Logs, I'd go with the west, because you're gonna see many more Petrified Logs than here. But the view at the top of that hill up there is something to check out on its own. So if you're gonna stop here and you don't wanna see the log, at least go up top to that hill. You won't be disappointed. Oh wow, so there's this historical marker right off the road. You'll see a sign pointing to it. What this is about is a guy named John J. Clark, who was in the New York infantry back in the 1860s, got honorably discharged. And basically, after that, he came out west. He was making his way, it looks like, from Bakersfield to Salt City, Utah, and on a buckboard, I think, which is one of these. And he went out looking for water, and when he returned, he crawled underneath his thing and died, presumably of thirst. So this is basically a memorial for that guy. I'm assuming down there is the memorial. See that white cross? Let's go check it out. Honestly, I wasn't really thinking of coming down here, especially since I know rattlesnakes are still out this time of the year, I heard. I think I'm making my way there slowly but surely. See, that's my goal. You know, it totally is just the completionist in me that has to go see this thing. The story sounds really sad and intriguing. I love pioneer stories, preferably ones without bad ends, so I'm into this kind of thing. And I made it to the memorial for John Clark. See, if you ever come out to these locations, you have to be an adventurer. You really just need to go check out the off-the-wall stuff sometimes, when you have time, of course, because that's what makes it so much better. You get really a deeper understanding and experience with the park. So my thoughts about the memorial, is it worth it? That one definitely is all about how much time do you have. I've been here 3 full days, so I'm gonna get to see everything, I think, so that's why I did it. But did I enjoy it? Heck yeah, I did. If you're new here, please subscribe to our channel. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Also, hit that notification bell to stay informed of any time we release new videos, which we do all of the time. And be sure to find us on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram under the name Cactus Atlas. Well, I really enjoyed seeing all that the Valley of Fire State Park has to offer. And I hope you enjoyed coming along with me, and I look forward to having you on a new adventure very soon. So keep checking back in, and until then, take it easy.